The second section under the TEKS for the first grade is creative expression performance. That doesn't mean that you need to put on a play. That doesn't mean that you need to take time out of your classroom and have everybody memorize lines and put on a play and have sets and costume. If you want to do that, absolutely fine, absolutely wonderful. But what it does mean is that we want students to actually do things. And doing those things can be done in your classroom. Now, there's four things that it talks about doing. And these are things where you're using your voice and your body. So we want to have, you know, your whole being involved in this to express something, to create a dramatization of something. So what is it we expect the students to do? Well, we expect them to safely use movement and voice. And that's an important thing, because there's lots of things you can do that are not safe. So think about that for a minute. Do you want to run around on places where somebody can fall? Do you want to do things too close to one another? Do you want to have, no, you need all those same controls that you're thinking about when you're thinking about playing a wide game on the playground. You want safety to be an important part of it. You don't want to accidentally have somebody get harmed because you were doing theater without thinking. Okay, so be intentional about what we do with things. You don't want to get too close. You don't want to run too far. You don't want to, you know, play acting in the first grade. You don't want to be dealing with stage combat. That's something that comes much, much later. We want to be able to create roles through imitation. So you set up a role. Okay, this is going to be a grandfather. This is going to be a grandmother. So, children, what would you do to sound like your own grandmother, your own grandfather? What do you associate with older people? What sort of movements, what sort of sounds, what sort of things would you add to make that believable? When they can do that to multiple levels, and it's fun, kids enjoy doing that. You know, imitate your teacher, imitate your best friend, imitate your uncle, your aunt, you know, somebody that you know, imitate somebody who's an action figure on the television. Then you can start putting together those kinds of things to dramatize a simple story. And we all know that English language arts teachers have lots of simple stories. So, read the story, talk about the story, break into small groups, and dramatize the story. You can also dramatize poems and songs. What a great thing to do, to be able to dramatize poems. When I was an elementary teacher, we used to go through poems and add sound effects with musical instruments. It's a fun thing to do. It's all a part of that creative process that is theater. Because anything that you do as a performance is theater. Do you have to do it for 500 people in the auditorium? You can do it right there in your classroom.